Financially Free with Cleo.
Hey, this is Cleo with CleoYogaFinance.com, and welcome back for another episode of Financially Free with Cleo, a show where we shift mindsets with real and raw money conversations with everyday people, empowering you to take action, appreciate the journey, and live the lifestyle you desire financially, mentally, and physically. Today's episode is going to be a solo episode, and I'm going to be talking about renting. Renting versus buying a home, and how renting isn't necessarily a waste of money. So I'm 36 and I've been a renter all of my life thus far. And I know sometimes people may look and say, hey, Cleo, you are wasting your money paying all this rent. You should buy a home because that's going to be a better purchase, a better buy, a better investment versus paying a renter, paying a landlord and making them rich. But honestly, it really just depends on the person, their financial situation, their lifestyle. You know, just because you pay rent, let's say, for example, you're paying rent and it's $1,500 a month. And someone says, oh, why would you pay $1,500 in rent when you can pay $1,500 mortgage and be paying towards something that you can own? But what some people fail to understand or realize or remind themselves of is that it's not just about the amount of money you're paying per month for the rent or for the mortgage. You know, when you purchase a home, it's different than when you're renting. You know, when you rent an apartment or you're renting a home, most likely you are paying for your rent and you are paying for renter's insurance. And then, you know, if something needs to be fixed, you know, repaired or replaced, you're calling the landlord and it's their responsibility to repair or replace things inside of your apartment or inside of the home that you're renting. But when you are a homeowner and you're paying on a mortgage, you know, if you didn't pay cash for the property, then you have to have money available to repair and replace things. So when you were a renter and you needed something repaired or replaced, you just called the landlord, right? But as a homeowner, you have to fix it. You have to repair it. You have to replace things that need to be repaired or replaced. You know, you have to call that electrician. You have to call that plumber. You have to call whatever professional you need to inspect whatever is damaged or malfunctioning, and you have to pay them out of your own pocket most of the time to get something repaired or replaced. So when you are thinking about renting versus buying a home, please do not only think of the amount you're paying each month. When you are a homeowner, it's a huge responsibility. You are having to manage and take care of property, you know, and that's going to be more than just what you pay every month for the mortgage if you didn't pay cash for it, right? So you want to think about that. You know, you want to think about how much money do you have saved, set aside to cover things that may need to be repaired or replaced. You know, if you have, you know, for example, you know, my majority of my, you know, career is in insurance claims. So if you have, you know, just because you have insurance doesn't mean that insurance is going to cover any and everything. You know, for example, you know, as an independent claims adjuster, I was handling claims from, you know, for example, back in 2017, when there was Hurricane Harvey in Texas, when there was Hurricane Irma in Florida, when it was Hurricane Maria in Puerto Rico, you know, I handled so many claims from that hurricane season. And specifically in Hurricane Harvey, there were a lot of people in that Houston area, in the, you know, South Texas area that did not have flood insurance. Or if they did have, you know, flood insurance, there were certain things about their claim that it wasn't covered. You know, their roof was not going to be paid for by the insurance company. You know, everybody's claim is different. I know sometimes people think, oh, the insurance company, they take your money and never want to pay anything. There are companies out there who actually, they try to find things to pay for. They want to pay your claim because they value you as a customer. And yes, there are some insurance companies out there that try not to pay any claims, but there are lots of companies out there that do the right thing. But you know, as a claims adjuster, I always have to follow what the policy says. And that's something else that's important as a homeowner, is to know what insurance policies you have. And I get it. You know, nobody is really reading through the whole policy, right? To understand everything that the policy means. But you just want to make sure that you read it. You got to read it, right? If you don't read it, at least skim through it and consult with someone who understands policy language and insurance policies, and that can explain certain things to you. That if you live in an area that has lots of hurricanes or have lots of tornadoes, or even if you have regular, you know, everyday type of stuff, ask them, you know, if this type of situation, even though you never know until something happens, but you can kind of think of different scenarios, like if something, you know, like this happened, would my property be covered? Or, you know, think about your deductibles and, you know, think about your limits, you know, how much is coverage is available there, right? So as a homeowner, you have to think about having not just enough to pay your monthly mortgage. You have to have money to pay for property taxes. You have to have money to, like I said before, pay for things that need to be repaired or replaced. You know, even when you move in your home, the furniture that you had in your apartment is probably not gonna, you know, fit well in your new home, because you have a new home, you wanna get new furniture, right? Even if you did wanna get new furniture, you probably have to get some additional furniture, because like usually your apartment or the home you were renting is probably gonna be smaller than what your new home is. So you wanna get, so that's gonna cost money. So you gotta pay for new furniture, additional furniture, and you wanna make sure it's nice and comfortable for you, right? You know, that's gonna cost money. And there's so many other different types of fees and expenses. What about lawn care? You know, there are certain communities where that's kind of covered, you know, in the HOA fees, homeowner association fees, but there are some homeowners where, you know, you have to pay somebody to maintain the upkeep of the landscaping around the home. That's gonna be a new expense. If you're living in apartments, you know, long-term, you may not have to, not may not, you don't necessarily have to do any type of landscaping around. So that's gonna be a new expense. So anyone out there who is, you know, thinking about renting versus buying, you know, make sure you are ready, because there are people who purchase homes and it feels good, you look great, but you're really house poor, as we would say in the financial world. Some of us, we would talk about how you are really truly in the negative. You know, you may be in this house, but you may not truly can afford it. You know, if you lost your job today, how much money do you have available to still pay that mortgage every single month, to still pay the fees and expenses required to upkeep the home? You know, me as a renter, especially with me relocating several times, I knew that buying a home, that was something that I just didn't want to get into, because before I relocated for the first time, I wasn't even in a financial position to buy anybody's property. But over the years of me relocating and working these different contracts and improving my finances, you know, I got to positions where, you know what, like if I wanted to get a house today, I could. But I had several reasons why I still continue to rent. You know, for example, if I'm relocating to different cities, I don't want to buy a house just to have to turn around and sell it after a year or two because I'm relocating to another job, you know, because you never know how quickly a house is going to sell. I personally just didn't want to deal with that. But if someone chose to do that, I just want it to be that their decision. So if you're making decisions on staying a renter, make sure that's your decision. If you're ready to buy a home, make sure that's your decision. But make sure you do your research. You know, look at the pros and cons. You know, renting in Dallas, Fort Worth, Texas is going to be different renting in San Francisco, California, or New York, New York. You know, the cost of living is different. So you have to think about, you know, your finances, your income, how much money you're working with, what are your money habits, you know? And also, if you are a renter and you always pay your rent late, or you pay it late sometimes, like over the last year, have you paid your rent late? And yes, I do understand in this climate, you know, with COVID, there are, in the pandemic, there are a lot of people who lost their jobs or their hours were decreased at work, you know, something out of your control initially, right? You may not have had any control over that, but let's just take away COVID and the pandemic for a moment and just think about your habits prior to that. Did you have a history of paying bills late, paying your rent late, paying your utilities late? So if you're already mismanaging your expenses as a renter, you might have a struggle keeping up with expenses as a home buyer, as a homeowner. So I just want to encourage people to understand how just because someone's renting doesn't mean they're wasting their money. Because honestly, in my position, I feel like I saved time and money continuing to be a renter and peace of mind, you know, because wherever I purchase a home, I want to make sure I'm going to be there for a certain period of time, especially if it's going to be my primary residence. Now, we're talking about, you know, rental property. That's a whole nother story, right? And of course, we know there's the house hacking, right? Where you can purchase the property and you can live in it and you can rent out portions of it, right? So we understand that there's so many different options out there when it comes to buying property, whether you're buying a single family home or a multifamily home. But the idea that I want us to understand is that renting does not mean it's a waste of money. You know, because let's think about people who have purchased homes, but they truly couldn't afford it and it was foreclosed on, or they feel stuck and unhappy in their home after a period of time because they realize they couldn't afford it anymore. And then they're struggling to make their mortgage payments. You know, that's frustrating. So in the beginning, you want to make sure when you buy a home, it's not that you have to be, I don't really believe in you should be debt free before you buy a home. I personally don't believe in that. You know, I feel that you can have some debt when you purchase a home if you're, you know, getting a mortgage. But honestly, if you have too much debt, I think you should pay down some debt before trying to take on the financial responsibilities you have as being a homeowner. You know, if you have a lot of credit card debt, if you have a lot of, you know, payday loans, car loans, if you have a lot of personal loans, you know, if you have, you know, your student loans, if you have like this overwhelming amount of debt, adding a mortgage payment isn't going to help, you know. Yes, you can still have debt or lots of debt and still get a mortgage, but it's a good idea to think about, if I buy this home, even though I may be pre-approved, because, you know, we all can get pre-approved and qualify for a mortgage, but that doesn't necessarily mean that that's the best decision for us right then and there. So just really, really think about that. Buying a home doesn't mean that you're better than the next person. Buying a home doesn't mean that you are financially in a better position than the next person. You know, if you are a homeowner, that doesn't mean that you're doing financially better than people who are renting. You know, if you are a renter, that doesn't necessarily mean that you're better off than people that are home buyers, because everyone's lifestyle is different. Everyone's finances are different. Everyone's, you know, household family dynamic is different. So anytime you really can't compare one person's, you know, life to the next, really, because there's so many different factors that can make one decide if it's a good time to rent or buy. You know, I know for me personally, my goal is to purchase property, specifically rental property. But that's just me. You know, I know that it's just going to be me. I don't have any other kids. You know, like I've mentioned before, my daughter recently graduated from high school. So I'm single and I don't have any other children. So I don't necessarily need a whole lot of space for myself. But as for rental property, oh, I want a whole lot of that. Because that's going to be an investment that's going to create more income for me. And more income means more options, right? More options, more opportunities to do more of the things that I know I want to do. So everyone out there listening, think about your current housing situation. Are you a renter? Or are you a homeowner? Do you want to continue being a renter? Why do you want to continue being a renter? You know, why is that working for you? And I'm asking you to ask yourself why, because you want to evaluate your situation to see, hey, you know, I've been a renter. Is continuing to rent the best financial decision for me right now? Because just because you choose to do that right now doesn't mean you have to stay there forever. You know, that could be just in your season right now. You know, next year, later this year, next year, in 2 years, your situation could be different. You know, are you a home buyer? You know, are you a homeowner? Is your home a home that you actually like? You know, do you feel good about your purchase? You know, no matter if you just bought it or you've had it for 5, 10 years, how do you feel about your home? Do you love it? Are you happy about the money and energy and time that you put into your home? Do you feel like you can be here forever or for long term, for a number of years? You know, if you don't feel good about your purchase, it's okay, because you can make a change about that. You know, you can sell the home and move into a different home. And if you sell a home and move into an apartment, that's okay too. You know, sometimes I get annoyed, I should say, when you hear people, and I'm all for a good discussion or a good debate. You know, I think we all are entitled to our own opinions and thoughts, and you know, we should be able to speak about how we feel about things. But when I hear people say, you know, automatically, oh, if they hear that you're a renter, oh, you're wasting your money. Like, how you know they're wasting their money? Like, if somebody tells that to me, how do you know I'm wasting my money renting? You know, buying a home doesn't mean that I'm financially ready to buy a home. And even if I'm financially ready to buy a home, that doesn't mean I want to deal with the responsibilities of a homeowner. Maybe I don't want that responsibility right now, you know? And that's how I was for a long period of time. But then you have people who are, you know, ready to buy, you know, and may need to learn more about being a homeowner so they can officially decide, is this the right thing for me? But then, you know, I've talked with people who, you know, are renters and they have rental property, and people will still ask them, well, why don't you have your own home, like a single family home? You know, a single family home isn't for everybody. You know, I know that's like painted as this, you know, typical American dream with the picket fence, but that's not everyone's reality. Everybody doesn't want that, and that's okay. You know, there are people who enjoy living that apartment life or city life, and that's okay, because they can be some of the wealthiest people and have investments other places. You know, there's other ways to increase your net worth or increase, you know, your investments without purchasing a single family home. That's not like the only way to build wealth, right? You know, there's so many areas in real estate and purchasing property that you can do, and it doesn't only have to be a single family home. So I just want to encourage you to educate yourself, ask lots of questions, watch lots of videos. You know, that's a good place to start, is watching videos on YouTube, reading books, connecting with professionals on social media, you know, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, all the things, right? But you have to be careful, because there are people out there talking and they are legit and know what they're talking about, and some people aren't. So that's why you have to just make sure you do your extra research, ask questions, make sure you're constantly educating yourself, because when it comes to anything, especially around money, things change often, and you want to make sure when you're making that decision that at that moment you've educated yourself and done enough research that you're making the best decision for you. So if you want to stay a renter, stay a renter as long as you feel like you need or want to. If you feel like you're ready to buy a home, then buy your home. Just make sure that you're in a financial position where you can support your lifestyle, your new lifestyle as a homeowner, because it's definitely going to be totally different from being a renter. And I'm here to remind you that renting is not a waste of money, because everyone isn't ready to buy a home, and everyone may not want to buy a home even if they are financially ready on paper, right, to buy a house. So just make sure that you are taking it one step at a time, doing your best every day, and having that money date with yourself every single week. Because when you are working towards financial goals in general, not just, you know, continuing to be a renter or purchasing a home, you just want to make sure that you're elevating consistently in your money journey, in your financial life. Because, you know, this is Financially Free with Cleo, you know. I tell people this show is about sharing our experiences, you know, our thoughts, our feelings about money. Not that I've made it and I'm good and I don't have any other goals. You know, I have other financially free goals that I'm working towards too. And I know renting and being a homeowner has been a big one on my list that there's just been a lot of talk about lately. And even before, you know, recently, but I just know that's something that I've been told several times, that I'm wasting my money renting. But With my lifestyle, it was best for me to stay a renter. You know, when I decide that I wanna be somewhere longer term, then I may consider getting a home or the rental property soon. So until next time, don't wonder what if, take a risk, and I will see you next week. Have a nice day.
You can be financially free with Cleo.